we needed to like do that.
I know there are three of us this morning.
Yes.
We're sending our love to Selena Johnson. Feel better, baby.
Yes, honey.
We love you, SJ.
We really do.
Yes.
Good
yes.
morning, beautiful lady.
Hello.
Honey, they are pretty to my left and pretty to my right.
Come through
right.
with it,
my
then.
My God, they are so pretty. They are pretty every night.
Come on now.
My God.
And in the middle.
In the middle.
It doesn't rhyme, but it's all good.
Yeah, but I was giving compliments to you all.
Yeah, well, thank you. We get it right back. Right. Back. Right.
Well, thank you very much.
Well, happy Thursday to you. Ms. Quad, you going to go ahead and name the day?
Yes, I am. It is Thursday, and I would like to call it a therapeutic Thursday.
Okay,
so
all right.
Do something that is therapeutic to you, whether it's taking a moment to read a book, meditate, or maybe exercise.
Yes.
Go for long walks, or just sit calm and not say a word.
Ooh.
Therapeutic Thursday. Try it.
I love it. I love it.
Yeah.
That's a beautiful one. That's a beautiful one. Well, let's welcome the good people to our show. Hello. Welcome to Sister Circle Live. I am Rashawn Ali.
I'm yours truly, Ms. Quad.
And I'm Trina Braxton.
Of course, this is the place where we talk about a lot of good stuff and we get to interview amazing people like the man himself. The man himself, Lil Duval.
Duval.
Yes.
Duval.
Living his bestest life.
Are you kidding me?
Yes.
They got him done. He's down here to the circle.
Down to the circle.
And is he going back and forth?
Not with none of y'all.
Anymore. Because he's living his what?
Best life.
All right, then.
Yes.
Okay, then.
I can't wait to see how that all happened.
Yes.
Because it sounds, you know how Lil Duval has, he's been doing his thing for quite some time.
Absolutely.
Making up lots and lots of songs. But this was the one that really has catapulted him to completely different area in his life.
Yeah.
Like, really.
And it's funny, I'm like, did you mean it for a joke? And then it just spiraled into this big, explosive mega song that is actually like inspirational.
Absolutely.
It really is.
Yes. I can't wait to delve in and ask him all the pertinent questions that, you know, let us know how he did get to that, how he started from the bottom now and here.
Yay. Yay. Look at Trina. I was talking about the reference to rap, which is great.
Okay, so
that was too much.
Really
too
good.
Much.
Really proud of you in that effort.
Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Quad, I'm really proud of you and your effort because you're doing so much for yourself. You got your beautiful nail lady coming every 2 weeks. You get your massages every week.
And I do.
And you're getting your dance on.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Now let me tell you, the people. There I go right there. Down to the dance class.
Yes.
And that is DJ, honey. DJ has us in a dance class, and I promise you, for like an hour and 30 minutes, he never ever stops. He's
always
high energy. He is so graceful when he dances. I gotta have DJ down here because, I think we should do. Actually, you know what I think we should do? We should dance with DJ on the Sister Circle.
Oh, you should dance with DJ on the Sister Circle.
No, we should. I dance with him already.
Oh my gosh!
Let me tell you, it's so much fun. It's high energy. The music is great.
Burning calories.
And you're burning calories, and you don't even, you don't really realize it. Sometimes, a couple of times I went in there, danced a child, he lifted up my wig. I said, oh, Lord, honey, I had to make sure she was down. So when you go to see DJ, you wear your lace front.
Yes.
Yeah, you can't bobby pin. You got to glue her down. Yeah,
you have to use extra reinforcement.
Okay. Yeah.
But I got to tell you, it's the best workout ever. So thank you so much to DJ for that.
Yeah,
have
love
a great
it,
time.
Love it. Mm-hmm. And Treen Bean, you were out in the town last night.
I went to go and see the premiere of Canal Street.
Yes.
One of our very good friends,
Amira Wyndham.
Uh-huh. He's one of the executive producers and the musical producer of the movie. That's me and Vaughn.
Who is that man? You want to tell the people who they are?
That's Vaughn. And that's Amira right there to my left.
Yes. Hey,
and the other gentlemen were writers, producers, and men from the 100 Black Men.
Yes.
Some of their representatives. Yes.
Oh, excellent.
Also there, of course, Montel Jordan, Ambassador Andrew Young was there.
Nice.
And of course, Jamal Bryant, who was a friend of the circle, along with these two gentlemen. And I just had a great time. The movie is amazing. You have to go see it, especially in this time of racial divide. Mm-hmm. I don't want to tell too much of it because I don't want to give it away. Must see.
Yeah. We're hoping to get some of the stars of that show, of that movie on the circle. So we'll see. But shout out to Amir and everybody and Jonathan and all the folks who are behind this this film. Just congratulations. And I'm glad that it was well received.
Yes, that's what I'm talking about.
That's good. That's good. Guys, I don't have any pictures to share, but I'm just really in full Uber mom mode.
Okay, then.
You know, I timed myself yesterday when I left the house to go pick up the first child.
How many hours did you put in?
Oh, I'm in the car. I could make it, I go back and forth to Tallahassee because I love to go to FAMU homecoming and different things like that. Many times I would almost be in Tallahassee.
What?
Absolutely. So if I leave my house at 3 to go get the first child by 3:45 and go back to the other school, and then by the time you do drop off of track practice and all that stuff, it's about a smooth 5:45.
Oh, ooh, my.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I listen to great audiobooks.
Yeah.
In the car. I don't really like to talk a lot in the car because we talk for a living. Mm-hmm. So when I don't have to talk, I don't. And so, yeah, listen to other people talk or I just listen to silence. So shout out to all the Uber moms out there. I feel your pain. But you know what? Just be blessed in the moment because there'll be a time when we're not driving them anymore.
Yeah.
And that'll be an entirely different worry. But I have really started to just say, you know what? It's all good.
Yes, it is.
It's all good as I drive.
Come on, mommy duties.
All right.
I like that.
They never end. I know. Let's get to the top of our daily feed. We talk about what's going on and do we have updates. The fallout resulting from the Lifetime docuseries Surviving R. Kelly continues. A warrant has been issued for R. Kelly's former manager, James Mason, mm-hmm. who's been accused of threatening to kill Timothy Savage, father of one of the alleged victims, Joycelyn. And now, if you remember, Timothy Savage and his wife were here on Sister Circle in June to share their story. There's a quick peek at that. And you can check that on our YouTube page as well. And before Drea Kelly made the rounds nationally, her first national interview was with us. So
yes.
You can see that on our YouTube page and you can kind of, I mean, you feel the heaviness and the weight then.
Right.
And now people are starting to see it, not only from these parents, but other parents of alleged victims, so.
Absolutely, but I want you guys to pay very close attention to the strategy behind this. I don't know if you see it, I mean, you may, but I'm gonna share it. So if we get the manager, mm-hmm. we bring the manager to the table.
Mm-hmm.
We pile on all the things, the evidence that we have on him in hopes to get him to turn on R. Kelly.
Mm-hmm. That's the strategy.
Because right now we don't have very many women, you know, they're asking women to come forward, but there is more than one way.
Yeah.
To skin a cat.
Yeah. And this is happening.
One thing about a cat, mm-hmm. the 9 lives can definitely be over.
Well, they have 9, and that's it.
I think his is over.
Yeah.
And
a lot of people who used to work with him, namely Lady Gaga, she spoke out about R. Kelly. She has apologized for working with him and says she plans to remove their 2013 single, "Do What You Want With My Body," from streaming services.
Ain't that nothing? What was the name of the title of the song?
Do What You Want With My Body.
Who wrote the song?
R. Kelly.
He wrote the song?
Did you see
the documentary?
In the documentary,
it was talking about how every song that he writes shadows something that's happening in his life.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no telling who he was talking about in that song.
Yeah. Well, apparently he was talking about all the ladies that he had as sex servants.
Allegedly.
Yes.
Allegedly. Okay, she said sorry for her poor judgment and for not speaking out sooner. And protesters have gathered outside of R. Kelly's Chicago studio that was featured in the documentary, calling for a boycott of his music, showing support for the alleged victims, and demanding justice. So I think we'll continue to report on this story. Almost, it seems like the fallout is like something new every single day,
mm-hmm.
and we'll be responsible in those efforts. Well, the iHeartRadio Music Awards nominations were announced yesterday, and Cardi B leads the pack with 14 noms, followed by Drizzy Drake with 8. Other nominees include Ariana Grande, Post Malone, and Maroon 5, who each earned 5 nominations. The show is set to air on March 14th, so congratulations and good luck to all of the nominees.
I'm gonna have the feeling for Selena for just one moment.
Go ahead, don't feel it. Yes, say it.
I feel like I'm channeling my inner Selena mm-hmm. right now and saying, while I respect Cardi B and her glow up, as you would say, and her rise to the occasion, I really feel like there are so many other people in different genres that were worthy of nominations
mm-hmm.
that should be recognized. And I just feel like no one person touches every genre like that. And I just, again, I'm here for you, Cardi. I love you. I appreciate and love your music. However, I just don't think that it spans throughout, you know, each genre. I think that there are other people.
What are all the categories?
I don't know, and I was gonna ask you, do you know all
categories? She's in darn near all of them except for country.
Right.
You know, all of them.
What are the qualifications for iHeart? Because I know with Billboard, it's radio play, and it's certain is like a group of people voting. Do you know about iHeart Radio?
No, iHeart, I don't.
Okay.
Grammys, we can talk about all day long.
Okay.
But this, I don't.
Okay.
But it's,
we'll find out more about what the criteria are, but I understand, and I totally I actually agree with you on that. But I mean, it is her glow up. It is her time, and you got to take it while you got
shine,
it.
Shine, baby. You got to shine,
definitely,
girl.
Definitely. I love her story. I love
shine.
Her.
That's right. Nothing in this world that I like more than checks.
Money, such a spending man.
Shmoney.
Y'all like, you had to get it. Why you got to get it? Stay with me. Okay, Jennifer Lopez is slaying the cover of the February issue of Harper's Bazaar inside the magazine. J-Lo actually gets personal about her love life, admitting that her high-profile fair relationships were her fault. Mm. She says that until you learn to love yourself, you can't completely love someone else in the way that is pure and true. Well, from the looks of it, she's definitely gotten over that hurdle because she and A-Rod are doing it, okay? The magazine hit stands on January 22nd. Is it fair for her to take the entire blame for failed relationships? What do you say? What say you, ladies?
Well, if that's how she feels, then that's how she, because what she was speaking from a perspective of self-love.
Yes.
And so if she is empty in that arena, she knows that, you know, and so she's now been able to identify with that. And maybe she's saying, hey, this was probably one of the reasons why, you know, some of the issues arise in her, in those relationships.
Yeah,
so I think, you know, it's a personal thing.
Yeah.
She always looks great.
Man, in every relationship, she's still bad. Yeah.
But I am actually finally happy that she has someone to match her fly.
Yeah. Okay.
Because it was, you know, that baby daddy and them children's
father. He used to be my boyfriend in my head.
Who?
A-Rod.
Oh, okay, because I thought you was talking about the other
one. Michael, what's his name, Anthony?
No, Mark Anthony.
He was not my boyfriend.
Yeah.
He's something special on the eye. SNL's Michael. That was so bad.
Rochelle, what is happening to you?
I didn't say anything. It was something special on the eye.
Okay.
You can take that how you like it.
Okay, we know the type of special you speak of. How about that?
SNL's Michael Che is taking a break from the show's weekend update to organize and host a comedy benefit for the same New York housing project that he grew up in an effort to chip away at the estimated $32 billion in repairs needed in New York City's public housing. Che launched an online fundraiser and is performing with Michelle Wolf and a secret lineup of comics to prevent the housing authority from being taken over by the federal government. The fundraiser points out that 35,000 residents are now without heat and hot water, and that number is expected to go up. So far, he's raised $23,000. I know that's just, it seems to be a small amount, but every amount counts.
Yes.
In an effort like this. So what a way to use your platform and bring everybody, galvanize the folks that are like you to raise money.
And what a way to not forget about where you came from.
Yes.
That's most important.
You're
absolutely
right.
Because our success is not for us. It's not for us to squander it. It's not for us to hold on to it. My. It's actually for us to share.
Absolutely.
That's right.
I love it. I can't wait till I get an award. I'm like, Decatur, stand up. All day. I'm telling you. I'm claiming it. I am so claiming it.
Yes.
Send us your thoughts on our daily beat at Sister Circle. Up next, a comedian who stepped into the music arena and found himself on the Billboard Hot 100.
Hey.
The very funny and talented Lil Duval joins us when we return on Sister Circle Live. He's living his best.